your service to this great nation of ours, and for your community work as well. Your support and your friendship over the years mean a lot to me. I'm so honored to share the stage with you, Skip. And I want to say, Skip, for you and your fellow Vietnam veterans, welcome home. Before I left Washington last month, I had the most gratifying meeting in Congress in a long time. It's served as a stark reminder for me why I'm running for governor of the state of Maine, and why it's so important that we win this election this November. I think everyone in this room knows that Congress can be, well, frustrating. You might even call it dysfunctional. But before we left for recess in August, we passed the most comprehensive bipartisan reform bill to fix the way veterans get their health care system. So that veterans like Skip and a million other brave men and women who serve this great nation of ours get the benefits for the services that they deserve, that they earn, for sacrificing so much for us as a country. Passing that bill wasn't easy, but working with my Republican counterpart, Chairman Jim Donovan of Florida, we led the negotiations to help write the bill, and I know that it was a struggle to get the bill done. But in the end, even in the most divided and divisive Congress I can remember, we were able to put a partisanship aside and focus on getting the job done. But here in Maine, what was Governor Page doing? Governor Paul Page will never be able to fix these problems because he is too divisive and too wedded to his ideology and too unwilling to listen to anyone who has the audacity to disagree with him.
Tax cuts for the wealthy. And where any program or service
health care to their citizens just last week. Governor DePage, new best friend, Governor Chris Christie, he even figured it out in New Jersey a long time ago. But this governor still doesn't get it. What he really doesn't get is rhetoric that he's been expounding on since he's been governor. It really has had a negative effect on Mainers, whether it's children, whether it's the working class, whether it's seniors, whether it's on firefighters, whether it's emergency personnel. His policy has hurt individuals here in the state of Maine. On day one, I promise each and every one of you here in this room, as your governor, I'll be submitting legislation for access to health care for the 70,000 Mainers.
Disrespect.
President Clinton as a proven track record that that is wrong. As president, he delivered real change for this country, and he did it by working